Hi, in this video I'm going to show you how to prompt ChatGPT to think in a certain way using a combination of knowledge graphs and reasoning ontologies, so that when you have a long conversation like this one and you want to make sense of it, you can actually apply a certain reasoning ontology like the one I have here on the right that explains the thinking rules to ChatGPT, so it tells it not what to think but how to think about this topic. And then I can query it using the built-in app that connects to InfraNodus using the MCP server, which is available here. And then ChatGPT will take these reasoning rules into account and provide me very precise and relevant responses that will be focused on the stuff I'm interested in and that will follow the reasoning logic that I ask it to follow. So it's like an advanced way of prompting ChatGPT so that you can extract the highest quality results. And here you can see actually how it works, because first it calls the tool that I requested. It extracts this graph body metrics that you see right now on the right on your screen. And then it understands, okay, these are the most important concepts in this graph. These are the most important relations and gaps that I should focus on. And this is the graph's implicit logic. So for example, it says here, if you want to interpret a biomarker well, because my original conversation was about biomarkers, you should tie it to the gateways, sleep, metabolic, mental, self-care, and use it to bridge the gaps. So here it provides itself with a frame of thinking, and then it provides me responses to the questions that I was researching, specifically this DFA, HRV, heart rate variability marker, and what it means physiologically. And here it's focusing on the particular relations I'm interested in that I outlined in this reasoning graph. So instead of giving me a generic response like it would do here, I have another version of this chat where I just asked it the same question but without using the graph, and then it provides me a very generic summary of everything that is written above in the deep research mode. Here it's actually providing me the responses that relate to the stuff I'm interested in and to the topics that I want to research. So for example, relation of sleep quality to overall health, like you can see right now here on the graph, or the relation of body fat percentage and self-care practices. So it's really focusing on the stuff I'm interested in, and then it provides me high quality response that will talk about all those topics in relation to my research. So it's really like applying a certain logic and making it work inside the context of your particular conversation. So if you're interested to learn how it works, keep watching and I will demonstrate step by step. First of all, you will need to create a knowledge graph inside InfraNodus. And in order to do it, you go inside InfraNodus here to the apps page, and then you create a new AI ontology graph. And you can actually also create it manually. For some more serious work, I like to create my own graphs using the Wikilink syntax and define my own ontology. But here I'm just going to use generate AI ontology graph function, which will generate an ontology for me. And I will say that I want it to be on body metrics, and then I will choose a slightly more powerful but slower model. And then I click visualize, and what happens here is that InfraNodus is going to use a GPT-4 to extract the most important relations about body metrics to health and to our wellness and longevity, and then represent it as a graph where the most important ideas will be the nodes, and if they relate, they will be connected. And I can also import a few more if I click here and go to the AI generated one. So I can add in a few iterations the topics I'm interested in, but in the end, I'm going to have this representation of the main ideas and the reasoning rules. For example, cardiovascular risk is related to waist to hip ratio. Waist to hip ratio is an indicator of cardiovascular risk. So you can see here it extracts some interesting relations, which then it can use as reasoning rules for responding to your particular research. And then when you go back to ChatGPT, you would need to also connect your ChatGPT to the InfraNodus MCP server. And how would you do that? You would need to go to the settings, and here in the settings, you will have the apps section. And in the apps section, you need to go to the advanced settings one, and then you need to turn on the developer mode. That's very important, because without it, you would not be able to add the InfraNodus MCP server. Then once you turn it on, you can then click this button that will appear there and give a name to your tool. So I'm going to name it InfraNodus, and then the name of my account, expert. I already have expert one, so I will do expert two. And then I will say that it's expert ontology knowledge graphs. And then here I provide the name, the link to the MCP server of InfraNodus. If you don't know what an MCP server is, I have another video on this topic, but basically it allows the model to connect to external services like InfraNodus in this case, and then everything else, leave it empty. And then when you click create, then it will automatically forward you to the page where you will need to provide the API key from InfraNodus. And in order to get this API key, you go to your user account, API, create a new key, ChatGPT test, for example. I will delete this key later, and then I copy this key and then paste it here. So now I authorized, and it's going to bring me back and add this as a server. By the way, you will see that here I have a few InfraNodus servers, and this is because I have several accounts that have several different graphs. And so it's a very useful way to do it. I can actually add several accounts in InfraNodus that I have with the different names, and then I can query them depending on what I need. So for example, here it's my expert ontology graphs. Here is some personal stuff that I sometimes want to draw upon, and so on. Okay, so now all you need to do is to go back to the list of your ChatGPT conversations, find the one that you want to extend. So for example, here I have a very long conversation made by deep research mode where I had a lot of insights about DFA, heart rate variability metric. And here I have this orange highlight appearing, developer mode, to tell me that now I can use my MCP connector. So I can select it here and use it. But what I like to do here, and that's a very important tip, is that I like to fork this conversation so I don't go into the original one, but I create a copy of it. And in order to do it, you have a trick. You just click on the share button here, and then you copy a link, and then you simply open it in the new browser window like this. You don't have to mess up with your original conversation. And here you deselect deep research mode, select the MCP server that you connected to the account, and you need to tell ChatGPT, fetch the body metric, the body metrics graph from InfraNodus and use its logic and ontology to provide insights on the conversation above. And then look what's going to happen. It's going to take this prompt, and then it's telling me what it's going to do next. So it's thinking now, and probably it's thinking that it should connect to this tool of InfraNodus. So let's see. Now it's calling the tool. And what I find works really well is if you write specifically fetch, because this is a system function in the MCP server that is understood by ChatGPT. If you say get or obtain or generate, it's not really going to work so well. So you need to say fetch, and then the name of the graph. You can also put it in parentheses, and then explain to ChatGPT that it should apply the logic that is found in this graph to provide insights on this conversation above. So it's going to take some time to call the tool. And here, as you can see, it made a request to this graph, and then it generated the response, along with some interesting information about this graph itself. And then it's using this information. It's actually quite a lot of data, so let me close it here. It uses this information to provide a very relevant response that relates to my thinking logic on top of this conversation that I was having. So this is basically how it works. You create the graph first inside InfraNodus, then you connect your ChatGPT to the InfraNodus MCP server, to the account that you're interested in, and then you use this prompt to call the tool and to ask it to use this specific graph in order to think about this topic. And sometimes you will get different results, so it really depends on how you prompt it and what you want to obtain, but it's actually quite interesting because you can fork this conversation into two or three browser windows, run the same prompt, and see if there is something interesting that comes up as a result. So I hope that you find this workflow useful. Let me know what you think about it. Let me know if you apply it to your own thinking process, to your own research, and what results you got. And you can also use it, of course, in Claude, in Google Gemini, and other tools that support MCP servers. So thank you very much for your attention, and let me know if you need any help with this. Thank you.